your GOAT, who do you consider the top NFL player of all time? The greatest of all time.
I don't know. I might come, I might go, I don't know. I might come, I might go, I don't know. Still don't know. I might come, I might go, I don't know.
Too sexy for your girl, too sexy for this world, too sexy for this ice, too sexy for that jack, yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for this chain, too sexy for your game, too sexy for this fame, yeah, yeah. I'm too sexy for the trap, too sexy for that cap, too sexy for that jack, yeah, yeah.
Okay, alright, that's fine, okay, okay. Feeling too sexy to accept requests.
Way too sexy.
And I'm way too sexy to go unprotected.
Way too sexy.
And she popped a Tesla, now she gonna.
Now that we on the NFL topic, we'll just keep it rolling, bro. Y'all got an NFL GOAT? Who do you consider the top NFL player of all time? The greatest of all time. You know, this is a team sport. You know, it's not played individually, so it's not like we can say boxing or individual sport like that. I know everybody got their GOAT for basketball, but this is specifically NFL. Who's the player that you would look to say he is the greatest individual player of all time? K-Dawg, talk to me.
Man, I think when you look at that, you got to be specific with whether or not we're talking about football and what position, you know, greatest of all time, and that's a big thing, you know. If you're looking at quarterback, I gotta go with Breeze. If we're looking at defense, just in general, man, Derek Thomas, who played for the Kansas City Chiefs way back when, still holds the top record for sacks per game. A few other records he still holds, you know. Boy was bad. As far as a linebacker goes, and Derek Thomas was good, man. But it just goes back to specifically what we're talking about, you know. Greatest of all time, to me, just overall, in general, probably Drew Brees, because of what he still is continuing to do, not only for the game, but for kids, for the youth, for the community of New Orleans, the whole city of New Orleans, you know, just things he's doing after finishing his NFL career. That's what makes you really the greatest, you know, is that your life exceeds past the sport you're in. You know, it's not all about you got the most touchdown passes, you got the least interceptions. Man, we talking about the greatest of all time, just in general in sports, even after football, even after his career was done and over, you know? This dude's still doing things to better not only the city of New Orleans, but pretty much the whole state of Louisiana.
You going with Drew Brees, you're good, huh? I hate it. That's a true hard Saints fan right there. That boy say, Drew, number nine. I'm going to pass it on to you. I'm going to finish that one off, copy at the end. I'm going to pass it on to you, man. What you think? K-Dawg gave a defensive GOAT, and I guess you can give a defensive GOAT and an offensive GOAT if you want to. Like I say, NFL is a team sport, so, you know, that's kind of hard to say. But, you know, if you had to look to one person and just say, you know what, this is my greatest player of all time, or who do you think in our generation will be said about? Like, we'll be old one day, God say the same. And these young kids that come up, you know, like they, a lot of kids ain't never saw Michael Jordan play, but they know he the GOAT because we all talk about that. We all say Michael Jordan GOAT basketball. A lot of them ain't never seen him play. But how do you think that'll be, you know, let's say 20, 30 years from now, when it's all said and done with the players playing today, who would be considered the GOAT of the NFL?
Yeah, I mean, I think pretty much general consensus is going to say Tom Brady. I mean, my thing is, football is, like we were saying earlier, talking about the playoffs, football is like it's a different kind of sport. Because, like, even in basketball and baseball, where you got to play offense and defense, like a sport like golf or boxing, you know, where it's like just you. So it's like depending on you, so you can basically rank person for person. Football is different because defense don't play offense and offense don't play defense. So like you said, I might have to go with two. If I was saying my favorite, I have to see like Ed Reed for the Ravens for defense and probably for offense. I'm gonna say for offense, my GOAT and my favorite is gonna be Joe Montana. From when I was a kid, you know, watching the 49ers, you know what I'm saying? They was doing their thing back in the game. And I always more like went towards Joe Montana as opposed to Troy Aikman. I just felt like Montana had, you know, four rings. And the only reason why I give it to Montana over Brady is because Montana threw touchdowns to win. Brady got him in field goal range, but Vinatieri kicked the field goal to win. You know what I'm saying? They still won. I'm just saying, like, Montana gonna throw a touchdown in it. So that's the only little mitigating factor for me. And because Michael Jordan is considered the GOAT, but Kareem Abdul-Jabbar got 6 rings. Bill Russell got 11 rings. So it's not really all about how many times you won, but really more about like how you won, when did you win, and who was you playing with. So for me, I'm gonna say on offense, Joe Montana, but on defense, I gotta go with Dion. As far as the mentality, knowing the game, the athleticism, and what you bring to the game. Like I say, how you play, how do you play the game? What do you bring to the game? Did you win and how did you win? And I don't think it's no other if you could say Michael Strahan, you could say Ray Lewis, you could say Lawrence Taylor. It's a lot of defensive players, but none of them really had that kind of swag, that kind of knowledge like you know. You know what I'm saying? Like, you run the Ray Lewis side, you pretty much know he gonna get you. You know what I mean? It might be a fumble. You know, you might get a few yards. You might break it. On Dion, you pretty much know you throw that ball over there, it's either gonna be a pick or, you know, you better just not throw it over there. So, I mean, for me, and like I said, football is a kind of different. I don't think it's ever going to be like a singular one greatest player for football because you got two sides of the ball. Like basketball, Michael Jordan played defense. He can block your shot and he can shoot the jam. You got baseball. You got, you know, you can hit a home run or you might snag a home run off the fence, you know. So it's like football is kind of a different sport. I think today kids is going, like, they growing up, I think for football, they see like Kyler Murray. I think they see definitely my homeboy and KC. You know what I'm saying? The young up and coming, it was going to be, I forgot, Deshaun Watson in Houston. He was in the group, but he had a little scandal. He got a problem with the team and shit like that. I think Lamar Jackson's going to be kind of like in that group, not necessarily up there. I think it's going to be kind of out of Kyler Murray and my homeboy in KC. I think your boy in L.A., he's getting up there, but I think they're doing too much on the Rams. I think they trying to get too many pieces. And your boy on the Bills, because the Bills got a big fan base. They got a loyal fan base. I think the Bills, probably the Bills, the Cowboys, and the Saints might got the most, like, kind of like loyal fan base. You know what I'm saying? Because, like, you got New England fans, but they kind of fell well because they was winning. You know what I'm saying? You got other teams, but they don't really. Oh, probably the Raiders. Probably the Raiders, too. But they got, like, their fan base diehard for their team. And I think your boy up there in Buffalo, I think he's going to be kind of one of them elite guys that's up there for the next generation.
Got a nice little crop. They got a nice little pool of quarterback up and coming, man. You mentioned some of them young cats. Justin Herbert over in L.A. Chargers.
Yeah, nah. He got to compete with
Mahomes in the same bracket.
I'm saying he got to compete with
Stafford. You got Dak Prescott looking like he coming back strong off that injury. You got some nice young up-and-coming quarterbacks to take the reins, man. If I had to just say one that's going to go down in history as the greatest ever of our time, probably even before with his accomplishments, is going to be Tom Brady. I don't think what he's accomplished as a player, as a key player on a team, will be matched. I don't see somebody else going to the Super Bowl 10 times, winning it 7. I just don't see it happening again. And what really set me, I don't think I ever rooted for Tom Brady in a Super Bowl. So this coming from somebody who's not a big fan, just admitting what it is. I think I rooted for him when he played Atlanta. That's the only time he rooted for him. I got the Atlanta background up here. Go Brave. Congratulations on y'all World Series this year, man. Past year, but man, when Tom Brady won that Super Bowl, they was down, I want to say, 18 points at the half, something like that, and he came back and won that in dramatic fashion. And then not only that win right there, that kind of put him over the edge to me, to say, because I'm like you, I was a big Joe Montana fan coming up. We saw him do some great things, but that kind of set it over the edge to me, that comeback. And then when he left New England and went to a new team and won with his first year with Tampa Bay, that's another thing that just solidified. Won the Super Bowl with a new team, that first year, new receivers, new coaching staff, new system, and just ran the table, man. Didn't play one home game, went on the road during the playoffs and won. You know, that's unprecedented, bro. I know Peyton Manning did it. He left and went with two different teams. Not many quarterbacks have done that, bro. So that just tells you about their greatness in and of itself. You know, we've had the opportunity to watch pretty much all of it in our generation. And I think when it's said and done, you know, the books are closed, you know, he's going to have debates. He still debate about Michael Jordan. But the consensus, I think, is going to be that Tom Brady is the GOAT of the NFL. Now, you know, again, it's one position. A key position on the field. You got to have the quarterback in order to have success. But if you want to talk defense, my GOAT would be Lawrence Taylor. As one of the greatest to ever do it, man. Watching him, he could just change a game. And his intimidating factor was something that players feared that dude. You know, like you said about Deion, man, they were scared to throw on that side of the field. And Deion affected the game in many different ways. You know, he'd come out on offense, and Deion would come out there on special teams, man, run a ball back, you know, a punt return, bro. And it was amazing to watch. You know, I used to like to watch Deion. He didn't play for my team. He played, you know, he used to beat our ass when he played for Atlanta, and then he played for the Frisco 49ers. He played for Dallas. You know, they used to wear our ass off. So I never really was a big fan of him. But like I say, Deion was great to watch. Lawrence Taylor was a different kind of defender to me. He was more along that line of your Ray Allen, like not Ray Allen, your boy from Baltimore,
Ray Lewis,
yeah, that you know, that intimidating factor, man. He would hurt people on the field.
The New York Giants first round selection, Lawrence Taylor, linebacker, North Carolina.
Hey baby, let's go out there like a bunch of crazy dogs, have some fun. You mine, baby.
God damn it!
Hey Sula, you better hope I never get back in here. I will kick your fucking ass.
He was just that grimy type of linebacker that could change the game, bro. So, you know, that just stuck out in my memory when he won that Super Bowl in New Orleans at the Superdome. I just remembered him as a young kid watching him coming up, Lawrence Taylor, on that Tecmo Bowl, the first game we played before the John Madden. You know, rest in peace to John Madden. He passed away this past week. before we played them game, we played Tecmo Bowl. Boy, if you had that New York Giants defense, you were shutting shot down with Lawrence Taylor on our first game. Who's your NFL GOAT?
I say. Well, I remember I changed that on text the other day. I know I'm on video, but remember I changed that to prime time. I had to reevaluate. Yeah.
Hey, you and B Dot right now. Who's y'all NFL GOAT right here?
Me, you know, Tom Brady, bro. I'm gonna say Tom Brady, hands down.
Why is he your GOAT?
For what he done, bro. I mean, all them Super Bowls, and he could lead one team. I mean, the first year, not the second year, the first year at Tampa Bay, a dysfunction organization. What they used to call them? The Tampa Bay, what? They had some kind of goofy ass name. But he took that team, man, and brought them to the Super Bowl the next year, bro.
Dak Prescott could have done it.
No other quarterback could have done it. Yeah, but no other quarterback could have done it, in my opinion. That's the GOAT.
I'm in agreement, cuz I called Tom Brady too. I mean, when it's said and done, I think the general consensus is gonna be Tom Brady, man. And I'm not a Tom Brady fan. I said that. I just think nobody gonna match what he's done on the football field. So I mean, who else can we call the GOAT? B Dot, you got a different GOAT. Let us know who that may be.
Yeah, I know we was my original pick was Tom Brady, because what we debating is just overall greatness. But in further review, man, I really, really start feeling that I'm inclined to feel like Deion Sanders, primetime, might be my greatest of all time, just because I take him even in football and outside of football, and what he's done as to be such an impactful player on every team that he's been on. I don't think it just comes down to championships, you know. Brady does have championships. I agree. He's got longevity with the Patriots, and then he turned around and did the same thing. Like Doc said, I agree. He did some great things, which is why they both in the conversation. That's why we talk about Brady. So I don't discount what he does, because originally he was my pick. But after further review, I think I'd rather go down in history and on record and on video saying that Deion Sanders, prime time.
Prime.
That's it. That's me.
Hey, I ain't mad at you, cuz. Hey, that dude was great in his own right. You know, me, Kay, and Kabiz had all gave a defensive GOAT, and we gave an offensive GOAT who we thought overall was the GOAT. Kabiz had mentioned Prime, and he said Joe Montana. You know, I said Lawrence Taylor and Tom Brady. You know, y'all want to mention anybody else on the other side? You said a defensive, so you got an offensive GOAT?
Who?
B Dot. It's just overall GOAT, Deion.
Yeah, I'm just going overall, man. I'm trying to stay away from that give the trophy to somebody or give somebody a consolation prize. If I want to know who the GOAT is, who
the number one?
I'm going with Deion Sanders.
All right, DOC, you got a defensive GOAT?
It's gonna be Ray Lewis. Ray Lewis, hands down.
Yeah, Ray Lewis for you.
Defensive, on the defensive side of the ball.
Yeah,
man.
He had a great defensive team on that murder charge.
Anybody that could go to a nightclub the day before a Super Bowl and stab somebody and kill him and get his homeboy to take the charge. Go the next day and win a Super Bowl, bro. He's a GOAT on defense.
That's what I say. He had the best defense when it came to that murder charge.
You can go to a club and stab somebody up and then go win a Super Bowl the next day. You're going to give that man the GOAT.
He got to be the GOAT up. For sure. Man, Ray Lewis was a monster out there.
But nah, I'm just joking. But he was a monster out there for real, bro. Just watch his films and stuff like that. And he was a holy person too. Yeah. Game changer. Yeah.
Game changer. No doubt, man. Well, you know, since we talking about, we still on the NFL, we gonna close out that NFL talk right quick with the picks, man. Who, you know, we gave our college pick. Who's your two Super Bowl team that's going to make it out the AFC and the NFC? And who you think going to win it all? Okay, dog, we got playoffs starting. Who do you think is going to win it all this year? Super Bowl, what it is, 55? Who you think? Down there in L.A.
Man, if y'all couldn't tell by my last answer, by me bringing up Derek Thomas, man, I've always been a hard, true Kansas City Chiefs fan. Way back. I'm talking about a long time ago. Always stuck with the Chiefs. I'm still going with the Chiefs, man. I think Mahomes gonna bring them back. They're gonna take another Super Bowl. At least that's what I'm hoping, you know. So I'm going with KC again, you know.
Who you think they're gonna play?
Man, I don't have no idea. NFC is up in the air right now, man. AFC up in the air too, but my true team has always been Kansas City, man. I don't know who's going.
Yeah, you definitely did the Chiefs, man. As long as I can remember, y'all had that relative Don Gripp played for the Grambling Tigers and went on to play professional football.
For Kansas City. Leonard Griffin, number 98, Kansas City Chiefs, baby. Always been a supporter, you know. So I'm still supporting him. You know, still supporting KC all the way, baby. And as far as the team they gonna play, man, I can't even call it right now, man. NFC is up in the air right now. NFL really is up in the air right now as far as who I see going, but I'm just, man,
yeah,
I've
always been a big prediction, man. We ain't nothing that's in stone. I wouldn't bet on none of them myself. Nah. Like you say, the way the NFL is going this year, hard to tell Kasem, the DOC talking to y'all right now. Gotta jump on in with the topic of who is your Super Bowl pick for Super Bowl 56? You got the Super Bowl being played in L.A. this year. It ain't been in L.A. in about 40 years. You know, they teams that moved out. Now they got two teams over there. They back in L.A., the Rams and the Chargers. But the Rams have made it. They didn't win their first playoff game. So I know you got your other team out there that you pull for out there on that West Coast too. So who you got, man? Give me your pick for the NFC participant, the AFC team that's going to make it, and who going to win it all. Talk to me.
And you know I'm rolling with my 49ers, man. Shit, they just kicked Dallas to the curb. Dallas going on crying and shit. They all out here crying. I'm in Dallas now and training. Man, them people hurting out here. I feel sorry for them, bro. 49ers took care of business. But I'm going to go out on a limb, man. I'm going to say they're going to keep it rolling. They're going to keep it on rolling. It's going to be a 49er and Kansas City Chiefs Super Bowl. KC? I think the Chiefs is going to be at KC. And then much as I love my Niners, I saw too much of KC last weekend, man. Andy Reid just pulled too many rabbits out the hat, man. I don't see nobody beating the people, bro. So, you know, wishful thinking the 49ers going to be there, but whoever's there going to have to play the Chiefs, and the Chiefs going to take it off.
That's yeah, I pick. Also got the Chiefs going too, man. I got them playing Green Bay this, I think your 49ers going up there to Lambeau Field this weekend and playing Aaron Rodgers out there in the frozen tundra in Green Bay, Wisconsin.
Yeah, I got Green Bay over Buffalo. I do want to say, the Cowboys, you know, they beat the Cowboys, but I mean, they beat them pretty sound. So I think, I mean, they got a chance. I'm saying everybody in there got a puncher's chance. I mean, from what I seen, L.A. won it. You know what I'm saying? L.A. laid the smack down. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, it's just game one. So we're going to see, but I think Green Bay, I think Aaron Rodgers, he want to jump up in the debate. You got Drew Brees just retired. You know what I mean? Drew Brees, he settled his career up. Brady still going. You know what I mean? Then you got the up and coming kids, Mahomes, Kyler Murray. Which Kyler Murray? Oh my God! I don't know what. Have him, he evaporated. But then you got your boy in Buffalo, Matthew Stafford. He's showing, he's trying to show out for LA. So you got a young crop, a new, then you got Lamar Jackson. Deshaun Watson was supposed to do something. We're going to have to see what's happened with that, but that's neither here nor there. But I think Aaron Rodgers feeling that pressure. Green Bay drafted a quarterback. I think he's feeling that pressure. I think he's going to try to win. I think he's going to try to take one to try to, you know, kind of boost his career and, you know, kind of boost his legacy a little bit. But I think Buffalo, just the way it's playing out, like with Tennessee being good, you know, Tennessee used to be the Oilers, you know what I mean? And Buffalo got a famous win over the Oilers, you know what I'm saying? I think Buffalo won it, but I think it's just something, you know, Buffalo again, because they went to the Super Bowl a bunch of times, but they never won, you know what I mean? So, I mean, just for me, I think Tampa, they got a lot of, you know, a lot of stuff going on with AB, you know what I mean? I mean, Brady going to always put you, give you a chance, but I think it's just going to be too much other stuff going on with that. So, yeah, my pick, I got Green Bay. I think Rodgers is going to take it over Buffalo.
Green Bay, Buffalo, huh? Yeah, like Doc had mentioned before you had got on, bro, all them games this weekend was really, really blowouts. I mean, the Cowboys tried to make it a game toward the end, but they was dominated. I think Frisco jumped up on a 14-0 quick like in the first half. So, I mean, when you look at the Raiders,
you only got to win by 1 point, and it's not necessarily what the score is. It's like, how did you win? Like, how did it, like, look at turnovers? Was it the, you know, was the offense? Was it penalties? You know what I mean? And the 49ers pretty much from the gate, they jumped out on that. So, I mean, I seen that from, you know what I mean? I seen that from the gate. You know what I mean? So
yeah, I said the same thing that first drive. When them boys ran it down their throat, I say they're going to lose this game. They can't stop the run.
One thing about it, Jimmy G got hurt. You know what I mean? Jimmy G got hurt, so
they got to go up to the frozen tundra next week. Frozen is going to be tough. But they, like you say, the Bills look strong.
And they came, but it's just statistically, you know what I'm saying?
Tampa Bay looks strong. I think they won by 20 points. The Chiefs put up damn near 50 points. They look strong. All the teams that won won in a dominating fashion. And that's what they supposed to do. That was the wild card week. Now you didn't shed that dead weight. Nah. Them teams that got that week of rest get to play. But we're gonna see what's what. Nah. You know, nah, separate the men from the boys and see how it go down this week. We'll revisit it, man. So we got Doc with the Chiefs versus 49ers, Cabiz with the Bills versus Green Bay. And I'm Green Bay versus KC myself. I got Green Bay taking it all. Aaron Rodgers with the double whammy with the MVP and the.
I got Kansas City taking it all.
Oh, you said Kansas City taking it all? Okay.
Yeah, I got Frisco and KC
going. Okay.
Going. But, you know, I want the 49ers to win it all. But you know.
Yeah, but you'd be happy to see them make it, though. Okay.
Yeah, I'm happy to see them there, but I know with the. I got the high test tell me that nobody can beat KC.
What kind of injury did Jimmy G have? He gonna play this weekend?
I don't know. Shoulder. That's the same shoulder.
Okay. Yeah. You know they got that little rookie they drafted.
Yeah, we got Trey Lance, and he a cold weather. He can play in cold weather. Yeah. He used to the cold weather.
But, I mean, you know, throwing a rookie into that type of pressure, throwing a vet into
that's a lot of pressure, boy. That's pressure.
You know, I ain't saying he can't do it. I'm just, you know what I mean?
They has not, they had, to me, I mean, obviously Tom Brady do what he do, but they have not been a more consistent quarterback to me this year other than Green Bay. It's just been consistent. Poise and they've been.
You done forgot what the Saints done.
That was week one. That was week one. That was week one.
He was there. He was there.
Yeah, but I mean, since then, he's been the most consistent to me. He's been the most consistent. Start to finish, he's been the most consistent. Week one, everybody had a game, you know, knocked some rust off. I don't even think he went to preseason this year. I think he sat out. He wasn't even going to play. And that's why I say it's like a storybook if he come back and win it. He done went from saying, I don't even want to play with y'all, trade me, to now come in and winning the Super Bowl, to me, that'll be an awesome story. But we'll see. All right, all playing out.
He got Green Bay number.
If they defense play like they play against Dallas, then. But Dak Prescott ain't no Aaron Rodgers, though. He ain't no Aaron Rodgers.
But the 49ers defense will make you look like that. Dallas was good. You could beat Dallas.
You got to remember Dak coming off an injury. You know what I'm saying?
Dak didn't look like himself, but he played good in the fourth quarter. He gave him another chance. You know, gave him a chance. One play away, looked like
trash minute. If that, they not playing him.
They had a few
first quarter, second, third, when they playing hard, it was already winning.
Dallas kept getting penalty. Man, I saw a series. They came out of a timeout, and they got sacked. And two false starts, right back to back to back. I was like, "What are they doing?
And two, that go to like the culture of your team. That's why Belichick and them is all like serious business, like military. Because the penalties will kill you, man. You know what I'm saying? You get a big game, you get caught back by a penalty. Now you down your. That's a big
turnovers and penalties.
And turnovers, that's a killer, man. That's what I'm saying.
Dak and them had three turnovers, man. You know, that'll kill you. But we'll see, like I say, bro. It's coming down to it. I think I got K-Dog got KC, too. So we got two Green Bay and we got two KC that have chimed in on the Plowbois podcast. Maybe they'll match up, Green Bay and KC, for the final game in February. You know what I'm saying? Doc and K got the Chiefs. Me and Khabib got Green Bay.
He done Dallas Cowboys lost, so he done.
Yeah, he can't say nothing.
I'm out. I'm out. I'm a Cowboy. You go watching the game with y'all.
Yeah. He an undercover Cowboy fan.
Nah, I'm wide open. I'm Cowboys all the way.
I thought you would have been like Tom Brady. Like, you know, you're the GOAT and shit.
Real talk. You do got a lot of competition in the AFC, like K-Dog say. You know, you got the Packers, A-Rod looking like an MVP this year. You know, is he going to take it? He going to do the double whammy, hit him with the MVP and win the Super Bowl. You can't never count Tom out. You know what I'm saying? It's your boy. You say that's the GOAT. He might A-B leaving. He might say, fuck it. I got to get it how you live. I'm trying to come out. You know what I'm saying? I think, like I said, I think when it all boils down, I think Aaron Rodgers just having a crazy year right now. You know what I'm saying? I think he trying to show draft the quarterback. So I think he kind of got a chip on his shoulder. I think that's going to give him a little bit of added, you know, kind of pressure. Same thing kind of like what was between Brady and Breeze last season. You know, whenever they won that first, they lost at the end of the season. But, you know, they won at the beginning of the season. So I do believe the Packers probably going to come out the NFC. Your boy Mahomes, dog, you know, you can't never count him out. Since he got to the league, he's been killing it. You know, he got the Chiefs in the number two spot right now. I don't know. And for me, your boy Burrow, dog, he was a talent in college. He's showing up in the NFL. He got his team up there. But like I said, man, the Bills, dog, they something to be reckoned with. They've been building for a long time. They finally starting to kind of catch their stride and, you know, start to be something. I don't know if this their year to win it all, but I definitely think they can make it up there. You know, Billy, she going to have his boys ready, but I don't think Mac Jones will. So for me, when I match up, you know, I think it's going to be the Bills and Green Bay, though.
Bills and Green Bay. I got you locked in, homeboy. Shit. I would never bet this year in the NFL. I don't know how this thing gonna go. It's wide open. I'm with you, Khabib, with the Green Bay pick. I think Aaron Rodgers is on that hot streak right now. They playing real good ball, man. Green Bay been solid. You know, that AFC. I think the best all around team in the AFC probably would be the Chiefs. You know, if I had to bet on it, but, you know, that's a toss-up for me. I think if the Bengals get hot right now, like they playing, they got a chance. I think if Derrick Henry come back for Tennessee healthy, they might, you know, with that home field advantage, they might have a chance. You never know with them. People counting them out, but they ain't get the number one seed for nothing. They playing some good scrappy ball over there, man, and they get healthy at the right time. It could be, you know, the year in the AFC. I just want to see some good games. Hopefully, it'd be competitive, and you have a good Super Bowl 56. You know, I think they're gonna play that Super Bowl the second week in February this year because they had that extra game they added to the season.
Yeah, it's on the 13th.
On the 13th, okay. February 13th. So we'll meet.
Preparations already underway for the next Super Bowl. The logo for Super Bowl 56 was unveiled this week. The big game will be hosted at SoFi Stadium in LA next February. It will be the first Super Bowl played in Los Angeles since 1993.
Again, after the game is played with our picks, I got, like I said, if I had to bet on it, I'd say Green Bay gonna win it all. Green Bay versus the Chiefs, I say that. Green Bay gonna win it all this year. I think, like you say, Aaron Rodgers coming back for that year he was supposed to sit out. It's a storybook year. They couldn't have wrote it better. Hopefully, you know, COVID don't play no part in all this and everybody gets to play and don't shut it down, because it's been a lot of people coming down with it and been having to miss games and this and that. So, you know, hopefully that don't cause, you know, some of the key players to have to sit in this playoffs, and we get to see all the stars be stars.
It may not mean nothing to y'all, but understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all. I want this shit forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine. I'm shutting shit down in the mall and telling that girl she the one for me. And I ain't even planning the call. I want this shit forever, mine, ever mine, ever mine.
Last name ever, first name greatest. Like a sprained ankle, boy, ain't nothing to play with. Started off local, but thanks to all the haters, I know G4 pilots on a first name basis. In your city, faded off the brown. Nino, she insists she got more class. We know, swimming in the money, come and find me. Nemo, if I was at the club, you know I balled. Chemo, dropped a mixtape, that shit sounded like an album. Who'd have thought a countrywide tour be the outcome? Labels want my name beside an X like Malcolm. Everybody got a deal, I did it without one.